Closer, but again, anywhere from I-85 north and west of DeWitt. Let's zoom in and kind of look at some of these communities and highways impacted in that polygon where we do have that tornado warning. So Butterworth, Rocky Run, there you see Old White Oak Road. Let me make sure, see if that is a continuous road here, is that moves right across. Okay, yeah, so that is White Oak Road. We had Old White Oak Road, but this is White Oak Road. And that is right in the path of a possible tornado. Again, we have even the possibility of damaging winds with this particular thunderstorm cell. Let me move you a little bit farther to the northwest. There's Route 460. There's Trinity Church Road. And then we start to get up into Amelia County. Ammon, as I showed you with the track there, there's Namazine up there in Namazine Road. Once we get up into Amelia County, any of these locations, you want to get to your safe space, an interior room on the lowest floor of your home. Okay, you want to get to an interior hallway, a bathroom or closet. Get away from the windows. If you have a basement, that's ideal. Let's go back to the radar view. And what I want to point out is, and what we will continue to see today, if we do have any tornado warnings, which we probably will have more before the day is done, this is rain wrapped. A lot of rain here. We can't actually see the tornado at all showing up with this version of the radar. That's why we have to use our velocity, which shows us how the winds are behaving. And I don't see anything that looks particularly strong in terms of the rotation. But we have the green and red. Normally we like to look for a tight couplet between the green and the red. There is some rotation, really a couple of areas here along this area from Rocky Run over to Butterworth. And I'm eager to see the next scan to see if we have an update on that. And we should get another scan in here momentarily, but let's zoom out just a little bit. But basically, if you live from Butterworth up towards 460, you can see that potential is there for not only damaging winds. Let's look at our velocity, because sometimes that can show us those bright, see that bright pink and the red? There's indication of at least some very strong winds with some of this heavier rain as it comes down. There's some stronger winds aloft that could be transported down, so you could get some very gusty winds, even if there's not a tornado there. But if we put this in motion, you see it's moving off to the northwest. Okay, so it's continuing off in that direction. So right towards 460, moving away from Route 1 and I-85 up towards 460. Now let's look at our storm relative velocity. And again, we have, you know, some semblance of rotation here. Nothing that looks really, really impressive to me at this point. But we want you, if you live in this polygon, to seek shelter, because even if there's not a tornado on the ground at the moment, it could certainly touch somewhere along this polygon area. This is where we're kind of focused on the area most vulnerable to a possible tornado. I'll zoom in a little bit more for you so you can see again where some of these highways and locations are. There's Route 85, Route 1, there's DeWitt and Butterworth, there's Rocky Run. Let's pan here and I'm going to show you that looks like this is moving a little northwest of that area now. So let's look at some of the streets. So we have Rocky Run there. Okay, so notice the polygon has just been moved. So Hills Drive. Let me zoom out so we can see. We've updated that polygon. So we have a little update here on that warning. So it does include, again, the north and west side of Dinwiddie County along 460. So Hills Drive, there's White Oak Road, there's 460, there's Trinity Church Road, there's Ammon, Namazine. So basically the southeastern corner of Amelia County, you are under this tornado warning. Again, a possible tornado. It's radar indicated. There is rotation within this rain band that's coming in from the south and from the southeast. Let me go back to the radar view. Again, we're not going to be able to see where the tornado is here. There's a lot of heavy rain. There could be some strong gusty winds in here, especially where you see some of that deeper red color. That's indicating some of the heavier rainfall rates. That's where we could see some stronger winds being transported down near the ground. So there could be some pockets of very gusty winds here along White Oak Road. That's White Oak Road right in there. Let me double check just to make sure. I don't want to be wrong on that. It's this road here. Yes, that's White Oak Road. There's 460. Again, this is moving northwest. So 460, we get up here a little farther to the north. There's the Amelia County line. And then coming up towards Ammon and Namazine, any of these areas, the possibility of a quick spin up tornado and even some damaging winds. Let's look at our relative velocity to see if we have a new scan here. This perhaps looks a little bit more impressive near Rocky Run. Let me pan over here so we can. Okay, I seem to have lost my control there. Okay, so Megan, are you ready to take over?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, thank you, Ross. We are going over to Weather One now. I want to show you the wide picture here. Obviously, Dinwiddie County and the southeastern corner of Amelia County is what we're watching. This is the latest tornado warn storm, goes until 3 o'clock this afternoon. So still 20 minutes. This is from, excuse me, the earlier tornado warn storm that made its way through Sussex County and Dinwiddie County in the northern part of Greensville County. It's moving to the northwest here at about 30 miles per hour. I did want to give you the first alert though. We're watching these outer bands. Notice here four tornado warn storms. This is in the southeastern corner of the state. These are also moving towards the northwest. So as these lifted towards the northwest at roughly 30 miles per hour, we will have to watch very closely in Surrey County, Sussex County, then eventually up into Prince George, if not Charles City County. So just be mindful of this over the next hour or so. In the near term, this is what we're most concerned of. This is a tornado warn storm. Again, this is the red box here. It does include Dinwiddie County, the central and really northern northwestern part of Dinwiddie County. And then this extends into the easternmost side, the southeastern side of Amelia County. Warning goes until 3 o'clock. This takes it right over 460. So if you're familiar with Route 460 in Dinwiddie County, make sure you're seeking shelter right now. This is again Dinwiddie County moving to the northwest at about 30 miles per hour. All of this activity is going to be very quickly moving to the northwest at 30 miles per hour. And these brief spin up tornadoes is what we're going to be watching as these outer bands continue to work their way into our area. So this is the latest velocity scan. We use this tool to see where the winds are going, if they are blowing towards or away from the radar. This right here is where we would see that very strong wind potential. Not really seeing a defined couplet at this point, not seeing any green, but very concerned about just as strong winds, if not severe wind gusts, that are working their way towards the northwest, towards Route 460. So if you are in this area of Dinwiddie County, make sure that you are seeking shelter. This is White Oak Road. This is where the worst part of this storm is, really almost right over Route 460 right now. And this is going to continue to work its way towards the northwest. In the northernmost part of Dinwiddie County, we have Browns Road here. This is just to the north of 460 as you make your way closer to Amelia County. So if you're in the path of this storm, please just make sure that you are seeking shelter away from windows. Basement would be ideal. If you're someone who does not have a basement, just make sure you get into the interiormost portion of your home away from windows, be it a closet, be it a bathroom. Take some pillows with you, blankets, cover your head. We do not have confirmation that this has reached the ground. This is radar indicated at this point. So there is signs that we could have a very brief spin up tornado. This is again Dinwiddie County right along 460. We'll wait for the latest radar scan here. Not much change with that. So the potential of a tornado will be possible. This is northern Dinwiddie County right along 460. I think the worst part of this is now north of White Oak Road, 460 and towards the north. We have a Browns Road, and then we're going to get to the county line here of Amelia County. We have Trinity Church Road. We've got a lot of very heavy rain. If we were to have a tornado, these are going to be rain wrapped today. You're not going to see these. So you don't want to be looking out the window searching for it. If you're in the path of these, you want to make sure that you're getting into your safe place. So if you're listening and you're in eastern or southeastern Amelia County, you need to make sure that you're getting into your safe place right now. We're watching this storm as it moves towards the northwest at 30 miles per hour. Wide view again here. This is all courtesy of Debbie. It's been raining almost all day towards our far western counties. Steady, if not heavy rain at times. Still seeing several tornado warn storms in the southeastern corner of our state. We'll monitor this outer band as we go through the rest of the afternoon, but this tornado worn storm in particular. This is the northern northwestern corner of Dinwiddie County. So on the map here, this is to the west of Petersburg. It's to the east of Nottoway County, and it's tracking northwest towards Amelia County, the easternmost side of Amelia County. Very heavy rain, and it looks like that tornado warning storm has been trimmed back. So this is again 460, moving very quickly to the northwest at 30 miles per hour. This takes it into the easternmost side of Amelia County. Very heavy rain, the potential for a brief tornado can't be ruled out here. Latest velocity scan. We'll always go back to this to see if we potentially have a tornado worn storm. Still not seeing any defined couplet here. No greens, but still indicative of some very strong wind gusts, damaging wind gusts perhaps. So make sure you are getting into your safe place. Northern and northwestern at Dinwiddie County. This is over Route 460. This is Trinity Church Road. This is Browns Road. This is the northernmost part of Dinwiddie. This darker black line here gets us to the county line of Amelia, then up into Amelia County. We have Ammon, we have Nanzamine Road in the easternmost side of Amelia. So if you're in any of these areas, make sure that you are heading indoors into your safe place. Make sure that you are getting away from windows, the most interior portion of your home. If you have a basement, that would be ideal. But this is where we're watching right here, right along Route 460, Amelia County. You're not too far away from this right now. It's moving very quickly to the northwest at 30 miles per hour. The warning itself goes until 3 o'clock. So we'll continue to track this as it makes its way towards the northwest. We'll go back to the velocity picture to see if we can get our latest scan here. Still doesn't look overly impressive as far, well, which is great. We don't want it to look impressive, but it does still contain the potential for some dangerous winds or severe winds with damaging wind gusts. So this is again over or just to the north of Route 460, and we're seeing the strongest wind gusts entering the easternmost side of Amelia County. This is all tracking to the northwest again as we work our way into the easternmost side of Amelia County. Very heavy rain. The tornado warning still in effect until 3 o'clock. We'll continue to watch this as it moves towards the northwest. And Ross is here with the latest information that he's been watching behind the scenes.
Yeah, Megan, as you mentioned, we have the tornado warning that continues. If we'll go over to the Weather 2 computer, you can see that goes until 3 o'clock this afternoon. Does include that northwestern corner of Dinwiddie County, right along 460 up into southeastern Amelia County. Again, that's the area that we are most concerned about. As Megan pointed out, we are looking at the potential for some strong winds with this particular storm. And again, it's moving off to the north and northwest at about 30 miles an hour at this point. And we are seeing, again, strong winds are the biggest concern with it at this point. Let me put this, excuse me, 1 second. I'm going to load my computer here. And what we're going to do is, again, look at this storm as it continues off to the north and northwest at about 30 miles an hour. Let me put on our buttons, and you will be able to see that we have the storm relative velocity, which we're looking for, green and red, that are very close together. We're not seeing that anymore, so not looking at any definitive circulation there. However, as Megan pointed out, we do have that potential for some damaging winds, because you see those brighter colors there indicating the potential for some very strong winds, particularly where the rain is coming down a bit heavier. We could have some of that rain helping to transport some of those stronger winds down near the surface. And you can see there is that warned area right now up around 460, and then coming across the Amelia County line into southeastern Amelia County around Ammon and Nazamine, right there in the southeastern corner of the county. Let's zoom in a little bit. Look at some of the roadways, and again, who could be impacted within that polygon where we have the warning at this point. And I'm actually going to actually show you some of the streets if we can. Let's go back to our storm relative velocity here. We can get a little better imagery, but there's 460. There's Trinity Church Road there in Dinwiddie County. As we go a little bit farther to the northwest, again, we're not seeing anything green or red couplets, which is great news. So what we may do, if the warning is allowed to expire at 3 o'clock, we will stop streaming at this particular time. But we'll continue to watch the radar very, very closely, because we have more thunderstorms coming out of North Carolina into southeast of Virginia that we're watching very closely. But there you see, again, this area here around Namazine and Ammon, this part of Amelia County, we could see some strong wind gusts in this particular area as you are in that warned polygon. Again, from Ammon to Namazine, there's Namazine Road. We'll come a little farther to the south. Again, Trinity Church Road, there's 460. So a much smaller area here, but again, it could be impacted by some very strong wind gusts, maybe a brief spin-up tornado, but again, we're not seeing evidence of anything that looks impressive on the radar at this time. This is our storm relative velocity. What we look for is a brighter red couplet up with a green color, and we're not seeing that at all. So that's encouraging news for this particular area. I suspect that we will see this warning dropped as of 3 o'clock this afternoon. Let's go to the big picture across the area. I did want to show you what we have going on as we go south and east of Metro Richmond. We have that one storm there that we're watching here to the west, but we also have this area here in southeast of Virginia. We've had multiple tornado warnings with this particular feeder band, the circulation around Debbie. And we talked about this earlier today. If you were watching us on our noon newscast, we were talking about the fact that there would be these feeder bands, and we were particularly concerned about one coming up through North Carolina. And there we see a tornado warning down in Suffolk, the city of Suffolk. All of that land down there is considered the city of Suffolk, and there's a tornado warning for this area, one for the southeastern corner, one for central portions of the city of Suffolk, and then coming up into Isle of Wight County around Windsor. Let me put a loop on this, and you'll see that all of this is moving off to the north and northwest. So where does it go from here? That's the question, and it will be heading up farther into Isle of Wight County. And then eventually we'll see this coming up perhaps into Surrey County. And then beyond that, it could eventually affect portions of Prince George County, perhaps James City, Charles City, maybe eventually New Kent County. So if you live east of I-95, let's say from Prince George into New Kent, Charles City, even up into King William and King and Queen, eventually this particular area here will be an area to watch as it continues off to the north and northwest. There have been some spin-ups down in North Carolina. We're seeing that down in southeastern Virginia, and that possibility will continue. Elsewhere, we have another one of these feeder bands around Debbie coming in from North Carolina. Even areas from Emporia south and east, we'll have to watch to see if any of these individual cells try to rotate as they come into south central Virginia. And then yet another feeder band, if you will, around Goldsboro, North Carolina, coming up east of Wake Forest. These might eventually try to spin up something into Mecklenburg. So basically our entire viewing area, with the exception of a few counties on the northern neck, you're under a tornado watch until 8 o'clock tonight. That just simply means that the conditions in the atmosphere are favorable for tornadoes. Does not mean one is imminent. If a tornado warning is issued for your area, obviously that is a more significant impact. There could be an imminent threat of a tornado in your particular neighborhood, and we always encourage you to get to that interior hallway, bathroom, or closet on the lowest floor of your home. Get away from the windows. If you have a basement, that is perfect, but a lot of us don't. So again, you want to get to that lowest floor of your home away from the windows. Let's zoom back in to this area here in northwestern Dinwiddie and southeastern Amelia. I do want to take another look at it. We have the warning for another 7 minutes, so we'll stay with you on this streaming channel until that threat goes away. But again, we are seeing rain here, very heavy in spots, moving quickly off to the northwest at about 30 miles an hour. Let me give you another view. We'll go back to the radar, then we'll go to storm relative velocity. Again, we do not see anything that indicates to me that we have a tight circulation or a tornado that would be imminent on the ground, but we do have that potential as we look at our velocity for some strong wind gusts. And that is probably going to be translating a little bit farther to the northwest as we get up here in Amelia County. So even along Route 153, eventually you could have some strong winds up that way. That potential is certainly there. Let's go back to the warning. Again, we have about another 6 minutes or so, so not that much longer here. And I don't see any reason that this is going to be extended for this particular area, but basically 460 and now into the southeastern corner of the county. around Ammon and Nazamine and that part of the county. So east of 153, just south and west of Lake Chesedin there in southeastern Amelia County. Again, that possibility of a tornado, but again, I'm not seeing anything that is really alarming to me on the relative velocity, although you can see what was that circulation right in there, what's left of what may be still some broad area of rotation, maybe rotating some, but nothing that looks like it's tightening up and that really is alarming to us. But this would be moving now into southeastern Amelia County. If the Weather Service were particularly concerned about it, they would extend the warning, but so far they have not done so. And with only 5 minutes to go, I suspect it will likely be allowed to expire as of the top of the hour. We should be in the clear at that point. Let's go back to the radar view, and I'm going to give you a big picture of our Channel 12 viewing area. And again, what we're looking at is these feeder bands. We've got more coming in south of Emporia. We've got the one here in southeastern Virginia. Anywhere along these feeder bands, you might get some brief spin up. So we do not think we're done with this just yet. We urge you to stay alert to rapidly changing weather conditions as we head through the rest of the afternoon into tonight until the center of Debbie passes out of the area. And we still have these bands coming in from the south and southeast. We'll continue to have that potential for a quick spin up tornado in spots. Hopefully we will not have any reports of damage, but you know, we're certainly going to have to monitor that as we head through the afternoon. It looks like the threat will continue again over southeastern Virginia. I think this warning should be allowed to expire here in the next 4 minutes. We've got a lot of heavy rain as you get west and southwest of Richmond. So even in western Chesterfield, the rain is moderate. We've got heavy rain in parts of Amelia County, Nottoway, back through Prince Edward County. It looks like we do have some flood advisories out here, if not even flash flood warnings for Buckingham, Appomattox, and Campbell counties. So it is that part of the region that is going to be at highest risk for flooding. Not to say we will not have some instances of flooding farther to the east, as I see potential another flood warning out here as we get into Charlotte County as well. So just outside the Channel 12 viewing area, we are seeing some flooding concerns. We may eventually see some of that translating a little bit farther to the east. The big threats from this storm system will be potentially some flooding from heavy rainfall. Winds are not going to be a huge factor with Debbie. We could have some winds that pick up tonight into tomorrow morning, gusting up to 30 miles an hour, maybe as high as 40 to 45 along the immediate coastline. But in the short term, it's the heavy rain that could cause some localized flooding and spin up tornadoes. That threat will continue through the evening. Let me put this in motion just so you get an idea of how everything is moving. Again, you get the idea that the circulation is to our south and west. It's basically coming up now into western North Carolina. The heaviest rain will be focused over this part of the region. Farther west you go from Richmond, the heavier the rainfall totals will be, 3 to 5 inches locally higher amounts. We do expect an inch to two, maybe as high as three as you get closer to the I-95 corridor. Overall, lighter amounts of rain as you get east of I-95, but there will still be some good downpours in this part of the region, and the potential for severe weather will continue. So another 2 minutes on that tornado warning as we continue that for northwestern Dinwiddie County, although it looks like that is moving out of the county now into southeastern Amelia. I do feel fairly confident, I'm hopeful, that they're going to go ahead and drop this tornado warning for those two areas. Obviously, if there is any indication that this might strengthen up again, we will most certainly break into programming on Channel 12, and then we will also stream here for you as well so that you folks can watch the Olympics as you will. And if you want to come over and join us, we'll be happy to keep you informed about what's going on. But right now, we're looking better here, although there's still some semblance of something showing up here in southeastern Amelia. So in future scans, it's very possible this may tighten up and we might have to come back in and talk about it. But this continues to move off to the northwest. Let me loop it for you. This is not strong, but there is still some hint at rotation as we're coming out of Dinwiddie into southeastern Amelia. There's a new scan just came in. Again, fairly weak, not impressive, but moving northwest. So east of 153 in southeastern Amelia County. Let's see if our warning is about to be dropped. got about another minute or so, and I think it will likely be dropped unless that couplet does strengthen in future scans. With so far so good. Okay, there we go. Okay, so that has been dropped. One more big picture, and then I'm going to get you back to programming. Actually, you're not on programming. You're watching this on streaming. I have to remember, we're not on television right now. We're on our streaming channel here. Again, we're going to watch this area down. This is getting mighty close to the eastern tip of Sussex County and then eventually Surrey County. These areas east of I-95 will be watching as well in the coming hours. We'll continue to keep you updated on air, online, and at 12onyourside.com. Take care.